You'll call it a perfect Christmas.
Of course I will. It's exactly what I was thinking.
I love it.
Mom, this is Diane Crouch. Diane, this is my mother, Julia Boyd.
Very nice to meet you. Pleasure.
Can I be your girl?
Oh, Carl. Carl?
Yes?
Who's Barbara?
Diane Crouch, Mr. Crouch's daughter. Where he works. She's going to tell us about the Christmas lights contest.
Oh, good. Very nice to meet you.
Hello. It's very nice to meet you as well. Come on in. Participating in the contest is an important career move for Mr. Boyd, and it demonstrates company loyalty and his willingness to go the extra mile. Plus, it is a great example for our staff to emulate.
Will we be able to use our own decorations?
Honestly, Mrs. Boyd, I don't think so. You see, your house can't just win the contest. Your house has to win clearly and easily. There can't be any question that the decorations in this house aren't by far the very best.
But our decorations are special.
Oh, yes, no, absolutely they are. It's just that, as an artist, to create the strongest and most cohesive theme, I feel that it is critical that I start with a clean canvas. But thank you for putting it on the table, so to speak. I'm glad we were able to talk. Is that you in that picture?
Yes. That's our wedding picture. Carl and I have been married 52 years.
Oh.
I still think of myself like this. I'm always startled when I look in the mirror.
Are you married? Not yet. But my strategy was, and still is, to finish school, spend 2 years, and maybe the first quarter of the third year, settling in store management. Finish out year's end, get engaged, then spend 2 quarters planning the wedding, and get married in June of year 4. I'll be 38.
Is it going well?
Right on schedule, as it should be. Oh, is that Mr. Boyd?
That's Louis, yes. And his sisters. He was a bit of a surprise. Are children part of your strategy?
Mm-hmm. 2 girls. 1 at 40, the other 42. And I'm very flexible about their names. Actually, I'm not. I have several under consideration.
Well, I'm sorry, dear. I must have missed it, but at what point in the schedule do you meet the man you're going to marry? By my calculations, you've only left the second quarter of the third year to play the field. Now, assuming it takes the third quarter to date and determine whether or not he's the one, you've only left the fourth quarter to fall in love before the engagement. Do you think that's enough time?
Oh, yes, more than enough. Don't you?
You can't plan a relationship in your daytimer, Miss Crouch. Fourth quarter, fall in love, get engaged. Not a scheduling issue.
No, it's not. It's a management issue.
A management issue?
Would you say that all broken relationships suffer from some form of mismanagement?
No.
Financial issues? Timing issues? Commitment issues? Loyalty issues?
Well, okay, I guess you could look at it that way, but love is so much more than that.
Then it logically follows that all good relationships, including the creation of good relationships, benefit greatly from and are in fact a direct function of good management.
People fall in love, Miss Crouch. They don't manage themselves into love.
They do if they're smart.
What about the intangibles? Faith, chemistry, romance, flowers, chocolates?
All manageable line item details. I'm not saying that love isn't real, or important, or the end game objective. I'm just saying, the better the management, the faster the success.
You can't manage a fourth quarter engagement, Miss Crouch. Well, maybe you can, but I couldn't.
That's because I'm a more accomplished manager than you are. The fourth quarter is all done on me.
Well, remind me not to show up at your door with a dozen roses and a box of truffles.
Fine. Don't show up at my door with a dozen roses and a box of chocolate truffles.
Fine.
Fine.
You can't manage love, Miss Crouch.
Watch me, Mr. Boyd.
Somebody asked me what is wrong with this picture.
Mr. Crouch, what's wrong with this picture?
Well, look around you, people. The answer's on the shelves. Or what's not on them is what I'm getting at. In the whole history of Christmas light sales, we have never, ever sold 2 truckloads of lights. Now, that's got to be a record. Now, let's talk toys and other kinds of gifts. Add in the ancillaries like food, clothing, all the rest. The bottom line, people, is that sales are way up all across the store. But you know what? We can sell more.
Yesterday was the largest grossing day in the history of the Great American Store.
Oh, yeah. And we're going to ride that hot horse, people. It's no accident that this store can be seen from space. Boys, I want you to order 3 more truckloads of lights, and I'm up in the ante. As of today, the prize will be not 1, but 2 free hours of shopping. Let's show them what double the fun really means, huh? What?
So you really can see the store from space?
Oh, absolutely. Hey, Santa, you're late. Look sharp, people. Look sharp. Come on.
Did you leave that, Eileen?
You hired a designer?
You can't use Eastern Star Electrics.
I said, well, you hired a designer. Who is she? Who's the designer?
She is French. She works for Pierre Domet, but for me, she's doing a special cover.
You can't cheat, Jack. It's Christmas.
I am not cheating, huh?
I can't believe you hired a professional designer.
And electricians from out of the county? It is all within the rules, huh? You have an Eskimo house on your lawn, huh? An Eskimo house is not fair.
It's Christmas. Winter, snow. We're being inventive. At least it's our own idea.
It is a lights competition. A Christmas lights competition. Not a theme park.
Read the fine print, mon ami. Lights, decorative lights, specialty lights, and other decorations. The Eskimo is in. Not all. Get it?
What about the Jews?
Don't you have a lighted Maccabee or something?
Ha ha, very funny.
You know, I think this Eskimo house is ridiculous. Stupid. Goofy, huh, Gary?
Too bad. You're really going to hate the polar bear.